Hey, I'm Patrick K. Compton, and this is a look at the construction of my Phantom of the Opera mirror, or Christine Daae's dressing room and mirror. I'm really proud of how it came out. This is the first set build that I've done since college years ago, and I think I kept a few skills. And a few questions came in I'm going to answer real quick. The size of it, the base is actually 10 foot by 6 foot, and that's 2 by 6s. Could have used 2 by 8s, but kept the weight down. There are four 4 by 4 posts you'll see in the photos that hold up the main black box structure. Those are roughly 8 foot by 6 inches. They're basically 8 foot on the deck of the set piece. That does not include the height of the topper. So the set piece is higher than that. It's over 10 foot with that. The size was determined by the width of the topper and the size of the mirror. Width of the topper is about 74 inches. This is the costume armor, New York City exact replica, because they're the ones that made the mirror topper. And this, is, I guess, is a vacuum-formed mold of that. And basing on that, you need about a 60-inch wide, 5-foot wide mirror to look appropriate. So that fact means you need about a 10-foot track to swing the mirror open. There you go. You got 10-foot. Another thing is the I went with Unistrut for the track, both below and above the mirror, that it comes in 10-foot stick. So there you go. It all works out. You don't have to cut the lumber sections because they're 10-foot long. Engineers are lazy. There you go. It all works out. On the track, I used nylon wheel trucks. If you look real close, you can find the trolley trucks that have nylon wheels. They make way less noise than the steel wheels. Most of them you'll find is steel because they're meant for really heavy loads, like overhead loads. But the nylon wheels are the best. The film in the mirror, it's a Mylar type solar film. Amazon, look for a BDS film for window treatment. That's a way to save money. I think the roll I got was around $100, 5 foot wide again. If you have the budget, I mean a Broadway budget, you can get plexiglass, polycarb, or real glass in a two-way mirror, but try pricing it of that size. When you're talking even a 4x8 sheet of that, it's pricey. It will break your budget. We're talking, just to give you a figure, $500-$600 to $1,200. And when you get to a 5 foot wide one, now you're in the custom range if they can even make it. So, yeah, the film is the way to go. Lighting, it's cheap lighting that you'll see on my, it's stuff that I had in my toolboxes and in my gear. I just used little cheapo LED American DJ Mega Hex Pars, which they still make. There are three Tri-Mega Pars that they don't make anymore. Those are the under-the-floor lights. And then there's an old-school PAR, low-voltage pin spot for the face light, and that is that's on a dimmer. So all that stuff, that's all DMX. The mirror topper itself, again, by Costume Armor NYC in New York, they highly recommended Krylon products for that. And you'll see the process that I went through. I found a brown texture paint that gives it kind of a stencil-y wood feel, texture, and it's a good primer. Went with that first, and then I put the gold on. And the who doesn't love the proscenium arch and all the gold details of Phantom of the Opera? It's just iconic. So, I love a stenciled look or a hand a gold leaf look. So that's kind of what I was going for, and I like the effect it gave. And again, a note for costume armor. Thank you guys so much for your hard work going all the way back in the mid 80s. You guys made one spectacular set for the Phantom on Broadway and all the tours. And thank you guys for your help with this project. If there are any schools or colleges looking to do this entire production, I envy the heck out of you. Wish I could be a part of it. And I really hope that this gives you some cool ideas for your projects. With that, I will cut away and I will show you a photo, a series of photos that I took throughout the entire project. And you can see how everything was put together. It was all handmade, all by myself, put together by myself. The only time that I had help was some friends with the truck and trailer to get the materials delivered. And a friend of mine, my friend Tim, came over and helped me lift up the entire mirror section in its track frame and all that, drop it into the deck part and hold it and secure it, because that would have been quite a task by myself. Don't think I could even done it with my little makeshift hoist, and you'll see that that rig that's on the man lift. That makes work easy, not hard. There you go. Now you're thinking like an engineer. Speaking of that, you know, I don't have plans for this. 10 years of engineering and AutoCAD and everything else, and I don't do that anymore, but now I just make random sketches on paper, and it's all in my head, and I can't even read my sketches. Just to give you an idea, I don't know if you can see this or not. Seriously, it's not much. It's just enough to get it on paper and figure out the amount of lumber that I needed and some of the hardware. So other than that, it's all in my head, and I was just figuring it out as I went. So I hope you enjoy this. Again, I hope you get some great ideas for your production. Again, I envy you if you're doing a production. I hope you enjoy. Thank you for visiting my channel. Please look at my other content. And if you like trains, I have trains. That's my hobby. I do tons of lighting for all kinds of shows. And yes, I do perform and sing, and sometimes as the Phantom. So we'll see what happens. Thank you for stopping by. Bye. Oh, one more thing. Before we go, Sir Andrew, Cameron, please bring Phantom back sometime soon. Thank you.